Okay, hey everybody, it's the Poltergeist 5000 back with more Chrono Trigger. In the last episode, I fucked up and killed these four panels without getting speed tabs from them, but good news, I did what I said I was going to, and I went back off screen and went back through the last little bit, and I got a bunch of speed tabs. I have 11 freaking speed tabs. Let me actually do some math here. Okay, so he's got 12, so it caps at 16, right? So, can we get everybody up to 13? I'm sure we can. So I would take one on him. She's already at the, well, she would need three more without the Tavon suit. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You're already there. You're already there. Why am I at 7? Oh, because I used my index finger to push the button. So now, okay, 7, 8, 9. 10. Yeah, I can get everybody up to 13 speed. You know what? I'm gonna do that. I'm just gonna go ham up in here. So he needed 1, right? And you needed 3. Although now you're gonna be like freaking Beagle Boost ultimate speed here because you're also wearing the Tabon suit. And I also gave you 3 in the last episode. But I mean, you have to use these speed tabs eventually, right? Okay, so let's get Robo and Marley. Maybe I could just have them in the party for a while, you know? What the hell? And I'll give... wait, who needs how much? You need 3, and you need... Oh, you actually need even more, because you have a dash ring on, too. Okay, you need actually 4. So I think I'll give you 3, and I'll give you 2, and that's all the magic, and that's all the speed tabs we have. Yeah, I'm crazy, I just did that. I just fucking did that. But now I'm gonna take off the dash ring, because he doesn't, well, I'll take this off too, holy crap. Excuse me, jeez, holy crap. There's gotta be some place I can charm more, like, vigil hats and stuff, right? Excuse me. How about the flea vest? Magic defense plus 12. I don't know. Maybe I'll just give you a gold stud. Because we have plenty of gold studs now. You've got the prism specs. I kind of like to have Luca. Well, Luca has the gold stud. That's nice. That's good for her to have. We need more gold studs. Never enough gold studs. Okay, let's get a move on here. Well, should I put Isla back in the party? I probably should. Like, seriously. One does not simply play without having Isla in the party in the Black Omen. We can deal with people being a little under level. Well, you know what? How about this? Let's bring Luca and Frog into the party. Let's lead with Luca. Or maybe we can lead with Frog. I don't know. Frog is a good leader. Anyway, jeez, we're oh my gosh, we are almost 4 minutes into this episode, and I haven't even left the first room. Well, I just did, but you know what I mean. Oh, what is this? Oh, this is the Labo spawn. Jeez, man.
Oh no, it's a mini Labos.
Jeez, we gotta fight another one here. Dude, I thought we did. Oh no, this is Elder Labos spawn though. It's called the same thing in this version, but if you play the DS version, this is actually Elder Labos. Oh my gosh, we're kind of beat up. This thing has two fantastic. Oh come on, this thing has two fantastic charms. I want to say a safe helm and a haste helm, which is just ridiculous. You can get your hands on that, you know, fucking do it, because you will not regret it, obviously. I don't even know why I don't even know why I think I need to specify on this. I guess I'll use cure. Dude, would you get that? What the heck? You're wearing the charm top. Seriously, I don't want to attack until I get it. you know? Oh, great. Lavos, oh god, is anybody not, I don't think Isla has confusion resist on. Well, it didn't affect her. It said disorder, and that made me nervous. Thank you! Okay, haste helm, that's the best thing. That's the most important thing. Now let's get that heal going. Wait, does he have a stud on? Because I thought heal cost 3. Maybe it only costs 2? Destruction zone. That's gonna leave a mark. And so is the probably inevitable counterattack when Isla uses charm on the shell. And we got the safe helmet. At least we got it on the first try. Yep, attacks with Labo Spawn Needle. Oh, only on her, though. Well, jeez, holy crap. Okay, get the full tonic. I can never find my full tonics when I want them. I know I just did, so, like, what the hell are you talking about? But, you know what I mean. Drop kick, holy shit. Oh, she can't even afford that. Dude, would you get a turn already? Thank you. Alright, I want you to have a mid-ether. Oh, that's gonna hurt. Ow. Okay. Oh my gosh, Luca's almost dead. I need to heal her. Oh, you know what? I think... Oh, I should have gotten into like, one random fight. Oh, damn it. She's gonna die. Hang on. And then you use a Lapis. We still need to get a heal off, right? Like, not now, but now. But, no, not you. Dude, she's gonna die again! Why does this always happen? God fucking damn, would you fucking put a lid on it for 2 seconds? You know what? I'm using a Mega Elixir. Who cares? Are you fucking kidding me? We are not having a repeat of what happened last time. There. And by last time, I mean the Retinite fight, that shit show that happened there. Dude, would you give it a rest with the fucking needles? 300? Are you fucking kidding me? She's not that far behind in her shit. Okay, let's just use... The thing is, Luca isn't actually a good character to have in this fight. Because she can't use... If I could just get a chance to use Dropkick... Yeah. Because all of her most powerful techs are multi-targeting. Even Napalm Bomb will hit the shell. Here, you know what let's do? Let's use Protect on Luca. There you go, that'll help. What the hell was that? Water Rise? What a weird thing to just do. There you go. Now she should be able to weather those needle hits a little bit better. Assuming we have to deal with any more and this doesn't kill him. No, I think this guy's about 10,000 health. I can't believe that shit. I fucking put in a Mega Elixir command, and he attacked with Destruction Zone in, like, the microsecond between our two commands. Dude, didn't you just do that? Like, literally 2 seconds ago? This is ridiculous. I really should have thought about this, but I thought about this fight, that Luca wouldn't be very useful here. Well, okay. This is like the only situation where she's not useful is when there are two enemies right next to each other, but one of them will always counter. There we go, Blaze Kick. That's what I wanted to get. Unfortunately, Isla's triple kicking stuff isn't going to be nearly as useful, mostly because of the MP concerns, because obviously the shit costs 20 fucking MP every single time she uses it. Triple Kick does. That's why I liked Beast Toss so much, because it only cost her 4. Maybe I'm using another shelter, because you know what? It's cheaper than anything else I have to get all us back to... I mean, we were in pretty good shape anyway, but... better safe than sorry. Maybe I should save again after that. There's probably gonna be another save point before the real boss, though. The real boss. No, you know what? I'm gonna go save again. You ever notice that Frog's running animation is, like, perfect with this music? What? Oh, more panels, eh? Well, don't mind if I do. Yeah, whatever. Please successfully. Man, these things are so annoying. These things are too freaking... You know, these things kind of remind me of... They remind me of Secret of Evermore for some reason. Like, that just seems like the kind of game... Like, I think there were... Like, I'm pretty sure there were enemies in Omnitopia that were kind of like these guys. Wondershot! Big ol' boost! Are there five of these things in here? Oh my gosh, if there are... Man, Isla does not... Luca did not need those speed tabs at all. She is a fucking monster of lightning quickitude. Yeah. Did we kill that one? It still isn't. Okay, now it's dead. No! How much health do you things have? I can't believe that thing isn't dead yet. You must be some sort of a genius. Stupid. Okay. Would you just chill out so Luca can get her turn? So she can use fucking Mega Bomb on you two. And then you can keep on charming. Yeah, there are five in here. That is crazy. I can't believe there are five Stop. How many times have I said that in the Black Omen? Just stop. That didn't even kill that other one. Holy crap. Why do these things have so much freaking health, man? Jeez. Stop! How is it that you all get turns between commands that we've already put in? Like, what is that, man? This isn't Final Fantasy IV. I didn't think there was that big of like a wind up on attacks in this game. In this game. I guess I'll use Wondershot on this one, because that one's dead now. I was gonna say it better be. Wow! Man, that wasn't shit. Okay, charm. Dude, Luca. Oh my gosh. Well, it's a random gun. That's the thing about that gun, is that it's fucking random. Man, another! I can't believe that. Okay. When I said in the previous episode that there was a room where you fought like six of these guys, I thought it was the room before the Elder Lava spawn. I didn't know there were this many of these things. Like, you barely even need to make two trips through this place to get enough speed tabs to max out fucking everybody. Okay, that's everyone. So let's do a frog flare. Just get these fucking guys. Just stop it. There's too many missiles, man. There's too many of them. There you go. Get the fuck out of here. Those things look kind of like Samus. Like weird. They look like Samus combined with that enemy from Dead Cells, that floating caster enemy that's so freaking annoying. Because they teleport away from you and shoot these fireballs that do, like, way too much damage. Oh. Okay. Hey, okay, whatever. I guess I'll save again. Lol. What's in here? Holy shit, it's us. I have never understood the significance of this room. Like, what the fuck is this? Are we actually at the boss, like, the final bosses? Oh my gosh, it's the Mammon Machine. It looks like a Contra boss when it's all messed up like this. Oh, it's Queen Boobs. Behold my pretty's destiny in its most brutal form.
all the dreams that might have been, all the happiness and sorrow you might have experienced. Gone forever! For you, there will be no tomorrow! The Dark Omen transcends time and space, waiting for Lavos to awaken. Destiny has led you here, and here you shall rest forever, unless you can defeat me and smash the Omen.
Yes, smash the Omen with our fists.
Come, dear friends, perhaps I can persuade Lavos to share his dreams with you. Did I say dreams? I meant his eternal nightmare!
Man! What a corny line. Now we gotta fight Zeal, get some more toilet paper. Oh great, halation. Yeah, HP goes to 1, yikes. Well, that's not so bad. I think you can charm a Mega Elixir off this bitch. I don't even really know. Man, I don't know if Luca was a good idea for this fight, y'all. This might be kind of rough once we get into the later parts of the fight. But I guess I can just try Flare. I mean, the thing is, she's got the gold stud, so I can just spam her most powerful attacks. I should have just used Flare, but for some reason, I always want to try Mega Bomb first. Just in case, like... What the hell are you doing? Oh, she's stealing your MP by making out. That's kinky. Will this do more than heal? I have no idea. Oh yeah, substantially more. Okay, I want to try this Blaze Kick. Oh, stop it! Was that supposed to hurt? Did I just feel a breeze? Was that your attack? Oh, the might, the pain, the toilet. Oh, baby, that was a lot of damage. Go, frog, hit that lady with your sword. Oh, we're doing this again? I think I have a little confetti saved up. I should have saved his turn! Lapis. Ah, star. Okay, let's just use Slurp Kiss, I guess. I would have had time to use Slurp Kiss. I don't know why. I don't know what I'm so nervous about. This is not a hard... Like, I think there are like 3 boss fights in a row here. Dude, quit making out with Luca! You fucking weirdo. Why are you laughing all the time? You're weird, man. You're fucking weird. I will have to ask Luca how that was, once this is all over, though. So that I can know if I need to put myself... Man, I had a joke there, but I completely botched the delivery. The joke was, I asked Luca how it was, because I still have two more chances to fight Zeal in past versions of the Black Omen, and have chances for her to make out with me. That was the joke, okay? Ha 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 ha. Okay. Man, Isla is out of HP, or MP. Man, would you quit doing that? You think you're so cool. Okay. Use a hyper. You know what? Use a full ether. You only got 8 hyper ethers. I can't believe I only have 8 hyper ethers. I thought I had more than that. Let's use Flare. Just use plain old, good old, bad old Flare. It might actually do more damage if we used, like, Flare and, Rock Throw. I don't know how much damage Rock Throw would do, but she's dead anyway. Not 1 Mega Elixir. Well, we just get 1? Cool. Ah! My powers don't seem to work here. Wait! I'll simply toss you into the Mammon Machine! That broke-ass thing. You'll be one with the Omen, Lavos, and me! So happy. What? What's happening? Aww. What is this, man? What? We can't fight the Mammon Machine. It's like a... You know, oh, it modifies all energy. There's some gimmick to this fight, and I do not remember what it is at all. I think it's like whatever you attack him with, like when you attack him, he gets stronger or something. I have no idea. Like you want to really hit him hard because something about that. I don't remember at all. I hope I don't die because that would be stupid. Magic becomes attack power. Attack. Oh yeah, that's it. Okay, yeah. Makes sense. What about, can you use Rock Throw on this thing? I got a feeling you can't, no. Even though it looks like it's floating in place, you can't do it. Well, that's a long animation. Attack used to increase defense, you didn't even hit the bitch! What? Wait, I lost track of that sentence. Ow, oh, is that the best you can do, seriously? Let's use Blaze Kick again, you know, let's just go ham up in here, I don't even care. I should be using Frog Flare or something. I really should have gold studs on more than one character. But the thing is, wait a second, I didn't charm this thing. I think if you charm this guy, it just gives you an elixir, though. That didn't do a whole lot. Memory machine stands still. Oh, I don't remember what that means! Excuse me. Point Flare, what the hell? I like how you can see it, like, reflected in the ground. It's like we're fighting on water or something. Yeah, it's just a mega elixir. Whatever. Using flare, I guess. This thing seriously looks like a Contra boss. Like, if you just rotated its profile, like, to a three-quarter view, or even like a full-on profile view, it would look like it came out of a Contra game. Yeah, point flare, whatever. That is like the least threatening thing you could do. Let's try dropkick. Inferno toss, what was that? Was he about to do something there? Or was that? Oh no! That was the name of a. That was the description of a dual tech. Holy shit, dude! Holy crap, that was badass. You fucking see that shit? I got the keys under my nose. I want to bake a cake. You know what I mean? Wait, I think the Moss Mini might have something about this. No. The hell? He just healed Frog. Wait, is that Luca's MP that's so low? That'd be weird. Dude, are you gonna die? Holy crap, I've done like 15,000 damage to you. The hell? Why is it healing him when he attacks? That is so weird. Like, that's actually weird. I hope none of the parts of the next boss after this absorb fire or something, because that'd be really bad. I might regret taking this plant. It's probably the Masamune that is absorbing his energy. Oh, he's dead. Well, there you go. What a lame way to end it. Oh, he just disappeared. Man, what an anticlimactic end to this epic doom machine. Oh boy, here we go. Oh jeez. I don't think I was as prepared for this as I should have been. This isn't a great team to do this with. Also, I don't remember anything about this boss fight, so I could be totally wrong there. All I know is that I don't have very strong multi-targeted healing from Frog. Oh, hello. Boy, you certainly needed a complex summoning sequence.
You cretins! I plan to live with Labos and control the universe forever! You will not get in my way! Indulgence has regrets! In the next life! What? Come on!
Oh. Oh. Oh!
She turned into Andross!
Like, Masquerade Ball Andross. Yeah, so here we go. This is basically like the final boss of the Black Omen. And the hands, you can charm some pretty nifty shit from them. You can charm a prism dress and a prism helm. But when you do that, they counterattack with MP Buster and Halation, I think. Or no, one of them counters. Only one of them counters with Halation. Okay, well that's interesting. I didn't know that. Yeah, I'm using another Full Ether. Who cares? This is like the penultimate boss of the whole game. What the hell else? Every single time I say hell else, what the hell else, I think about Hell-El, and I'm like, this isn't Shin Megami Tensei. Okay, let's try Frog Flare. Let's not, and say we didn't. Let's use Red Pin, because the thing is, you don't really want to attack the hands. Man, that looks so stupid! Jeez. You have no idea how stupid that looked, man. You can't shave off somebody's life with the back of your hand. It's like she was... Oh, man. Ow. It barely did anything, but it was enough to kill her. Hexagon miss. What the hell are all these attacks? Like, this is some whack-ass shit. Oh my gosh, it was strong, though! Okay. And use a Mega Elixir, like, as soon as that happens. Dude! Okay, do not attack Isla right now, whatever the fuck you do. Okay, we got the attack, we got all the shit off, now it's time. I think it's time for Luca and Isla to go at it with the regular attacks here. Well, Frog keeps everybody alive. Man, I can't see, like, when... I can't see when I'm targeting the head, because the targeting reticule... I never realized this thing actually... Oh, come on! That thing is separated from other things that anchor it in place as shit. Don't even give me that crap about, oh, can't rock throw me. Whatever. Man, that is, like, barely more effective than a Lapis. This is gonna be bad. I like that pose there, where she's got, like, both hands clenched. That's badass. Okay, anyway. I can't really tell when I'm targeting the head, because the pointer is hidden behind the description of the tech when I do it. I think you only have to kill the head here, which is good, because, 573, 572, 570. So about, like, how much damage is that in total? It's like... 1710 or something? I don't know. Because it's like 1500 plus 210. But then also like 5, so I guess it's like 1715 or something. Who cares? Oh my gosh, who cares? I'm surprised that actually does more damage. It always feels weaker when it's a move that, you know, hits multiple times for less damage. Unless it's like a whole bunch, like Hasu Kobe. Man, is it just me or am I making a lot of like like sounds in the mic, you know? I'm getting a lot of that aerated vowel and consonant fuck, you know? Would you go attacking Luca? There are other people in the party, you know. I guess I should use heal, but... To be honest, I don't really feel threatened by this. Like, it hasn't really done much that's caused me to really think I needed to worry, except kill Isla. Oh, fuck. That was a really fucking bad time for you to do that, man. That was, like, the worst fucking time for you to do that. This is really bad. Like, not to put too fine a point on ranking shitty things, but this is awful. Come on, get a turn! Mega Elixir. Ah, praise be to Yevon. Star! Alright, let's get back to business. I guess the trick here is to not use everybody's turns all at once. Like, try and space out the turns a little better, which I haven't been doing in this LP at all, because, like, usually you don't need to worry about that much. But it's worth thinking about here. See, like, Frog doesn't really have any attacks that really do that well with single techs. So I almost feel like, well, what's the point? Which, dude, I can't believe, like, your fixation with Luca. First you were making out with her all the time, now you're only attacking her? What is going on? Seriously, like, I may as well have brought Marley into this for the amount of, you know, party-wide healing I'm not needing. Are we almost done here? Like, I feel like I've done enough damage to last a lifetime here. Let's use Dropkick. We recovered from the last halation. It's just like in Iconoclasts when Agent Black knocks you down to like one hit, knocks you down to one health, but then doesn't do anything for like 10 seconds after that. Okay, well, there you go. That wasn't so bad. It was that one scare, but oh, you're still alive?
How dare you insects come after me! Oh, almighty Lavos, lend me your power! And I'm gonna cry!
What? Oh, jeez, what the hell is happening? What are you doing? Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. How are you still alive? I just kicked your ass like 3 times.
At last, Lavos awakens! Compared with him, you are like germs. But I shall obtain immortality.
Well, I think that's the last you ever see of her, so who knows. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. Oh, no. Oh, no. No, quit yelling, man. You're so annoying. Well, here we are, right back where we started. Right. What? Dude, this is supposed to happen for another 999 years. Was that legible at all? I said that so fast, even I had trouble understanding it. Dude. What? We're doing this right now? What? I thought you had a chance to escape. What? Oh, great. The background is making my capture freak out. That's great. Just what we needed for the final freaking battle, for the background to be too intense for my emulator / computer to handle. I don't need Isla in the party anymore, so I'm gonna take her out and put somebody else in. I can't believe you can actually do this right like here. I guess we have to do this now. I guess we have to fucking fight. I know you get a chance to leave later. Like, after the first phase, because Lavos has, like, 3 phases. I thought you could wait until much later. Or I thought you could back out, like, before even the first phase, but I guess not. Who should I bring in? Well, how about we just get a full-on healing jamboree? Like, all three characters who can heal like crazy. Now let's just, get everybody equipped properly. You've got the dash ring, that's fine. You've got a gold stud, that's good. Maybe you should, well, you don't really need a gold stud, do you? Because you don't really have that much offensive potential, period. You got the moon armor, vigil hat, rainbow helm. Oh, prism. Oh man, prism helm. Oh, baby. Yeah, let's get the prism helm on. You got prism for days. Do I have any more of those? Vigil helms? Yeah, vigil hat here. I'll give you the haste helm because you're crazy. And you can have the vigil. Well, no, you've already got the Nova armor. You don't need the vigil hat. We have 2 haste helms though, man. Jeez, that is crazy. And you've got the vigil hat. I guess this is pretty much good. I just need to heal up Marley a bit. And give us some ethers. Like, shut up, bitch. Get me an ether. Anyway, okay, let's do this, Zounds. Oh, boy. I can't believe I have to do this right now. Now, see, here's the thing. The first few phases of this are basically rehashes of bosses you've already fought. So it's pretty lame from the get-go. It takes a really long time for this boss fight to actually get interesting. So, oh, you know, let's use ice water. Get those Magus Castle flashbacks. There's not really much point to buffing until maybe you get to the Giga Gaia part, because spoilers, Giga Gaia is going to be one of the last things that happens. I think Giga Gaia is the last boss this guy parrots. That didn't do a lot of damage. Yeah, now he's copying that thing for whatever that's worth, that random boss that appeared out of nowhere. We killed it and then we never spoke of it again. Why is he copying that thing? I guess here's the thing. It all harkens back to what this whole like, the whole idea behind Lavos, that he's a parasite that leeches off on entire planets, like... Blade Toss? What the hell? That's a weird name for it. Massive Ice Attack! Oh. Okay, let's use Ice Water. Yeah, that is basically like, by mooching off the DNA and the genetic material of an entire planet across, like, millennia, like, eons, Lavos collects enough genetic material to create a perfect, to perfect its own, like, genetic makeup, and takes the best of all, it takes the best of everything that the world can offer and uses it to make its perfect body. It's something out of freaking Dragon Ball or something. It's crazy. Which makes sense, considering that this game was designed by Toriyama. Or, like, the character designs were. Boom, boom, boom! Well, you're not dead yet? Seriously? Holy crap. Wouldn't have expected that. Man, you are not taking shit from shit. What? Oh, this is Heckran. He's got, like, a bajillion special defense or whatever. Let's use Shock. You know, let's just have some fun here. Because the first parts of this fight are basically a joke. Oh my gosh, we're up to a gig on the recording. Too many fancy backgrounds. I am recording this in a fairly large resolution. 768 by 672, which is a weird-ass resolution, I know. But, do we have any more, like, man, this is not really a great party for dual techs, is it? Man, did you see how stupid, did you see how hilarious Robo looked jumping into the middle of the screen to use that with his, like, hand? Yeah, with his, like, hand. What boss is this? I wasn't even paying attention. What boss is this? Is this the Black Tyranno? No. What is this? What? Huh? Oh. It's dead. Okay. What boss was that? Okay, now we're in Masamune. What boss was that? What was the last boss? I didn't see, man. I wasn't paying attention. Man, my eyes... I wish my eyes were cockjacking, man. Ech. Well, obviously we need to get some ethers up on Marley. Probably not that much, because she doesn't use much MP anyway. I don't think Marley has a single tech that costs more than 10 MP. Honestly, Uzi Punch and Glacier should kill this. Should kill him right away here. I don't think Masamune has that much health. Maybe 4,000. Man, I really gotta... I might have to wait to record the finale to this game until I get the new computer. Because the final fight's background is even crazier than this. Oh, it's Nisbell. Oh gosh, it's Moundo. Oh my gosh, how many of these are there? There's too many of them. Ice Tackle, Orb, Beagle Boost. Nah, just use Uzi Punch. What do you think you're doing? Oh, you know what? That's not gonna do jack shit because this guy's a dinosaur. What are you talking about, Tristan? That's just the purple dinosaur. So stupid, man. Alright, that'll lower his defense. So, Frog, you can go at it with the physical attack. And you can get the Uzi Punch going. Oh, you're still alive? Okay. I didn't see how much damage Glacier did. I've been so bad about that, like, not looking at the screen when the damage numbers come up. Because I'm too busy looking at something else. Or just, like, looking away, trying to distract myself so that my brain keeps, like, subconsciously and absentmindedly coming up with commentary. Oh, great, Magus. Awesome. I guess I could switch out my party members, but, who cares. Why are both of, like, the... Why are there, like, two healer characters? Well, I don't know if Frog really counts as a healer, but... See, the thing is, Robo can hit three... Actually, can Robo even hit with his, No, not you. Can he even hit with Area Bomb? No, he can't. Okay, never mind. Okay, what's your angle, Deviant? Butch it, butch ow! Boy, that's weird. Okay, what is your... Dude, show me what barrier you're using. He just walks over there so casually. Barrier change. Oh, man. I thought it was gonna show... Man, he moves out to use lightning. That looks so weird. Holy crap. Shoot! Fire! No! Oh, man, that's like the one element I can't hit here. I can hit shadow, I can hit lightning, I can hit water, but I can't hit fire. Because Robo's... I would be able to hit fire if Robo would stand just a little... Dude! If Robo would stand just a little bit closer, I would be able to hit fire here, but... He doesn't feel like moving. So please, for the love of crap, change something that isn't fire. Dude! You're being a real piece of work, Lavos! I tell you what, you're being a real piece of work! Okay, ice. I'm gonna take this off. I'm gonna wait for Glacier. So we can do, like, a fuckload of damage here. Stretch! Oh, gosh! Man, this is really chewing through my hard drive space, this background. What, did that work? Oh, are we already going on to dark matter here? Holy crap. Didn't expect that. Doom. Uzi punch! Yeah, okay, we are in dark matter territory now. He's lowering his guard to begin casting a spell. Let's use, one of these. Let's use Bubble Snap. That's fun. That should be fun. And I'll haste Frog so we can keep doing that fat. Man, that looks so stupid. Like that would actually do that much damage, dropping Robo on him. Oh, he's dead. Okay. Oh, here's the Black Tyranno. Oh my gosh, this is the longest fight ever! This is seriously gonna be like... This is gonna be like a 50-minute long episode. I thought you could leave before... I was gonna go fight Specchio, man! Okay, you haste him, I guess. You use shock. Damage all enemies with max shock. Max shock? What the fuck is max shock? That sound is so cool. That it makes there. Oh, what are you doing? Man, it even kind of looks like Azala. Oh, she's laughing. She's so happy. Ah, the lag. The lag. Lagvos. So dumb. I can't name the episode that, though. Because if I name the episode that, then you'll know that I had to fight Lavos in this episode. And I want it to be a surprise. I want everybody to, like, click on this video thinking it's only gonna be me finishing the Black Omen, and then, like, well, I guess most people probably know. Dude, would you lower your guard and begin casting a spell already? Seriously, I know you're gonna do it eventually. There you go. Good job, Marley. Way to lay into him. Oh, baby. The pain. Let's use ice. Oh, let's use bubble snap. Yeah, let's use bubble snap. Get a bunch of damage in there going. Man, that does not do a lot of damage. Bubble snap. I guess you can keep using ice. whatever. Man, I wish Marley had a third attack spell. If I could mod this game, I would totally do that. I would change up Marley's moveset and give her something more useful as her final tech than Arise. You know, chicken arise. Arise, chicken, arise. That sound is so silly sounding. Alright, that's it for his MP, so I should give him an ether. I should get him an ether. I finally learned the story behind Get Me an Ether fairly recently, actually. I think I was recording with Tim doing the Earthbound race or something. And I asked him, he's like, what is that from? And it's from Kingdom Hearts. There's like these bunnies or something. Or maybe it was a flower. And the first thing they say to you when you talk to them is, get me an ether. It's like, something is just hilarious about that. The first thing they say to you is, get me an ether. It's like, shut up, bitch.
Stretch. Ooh, baby. Ah, the pain, 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 the pain.
Dead. This guy's gotta be dead here soon. Yeah, I was gonna say. Oh my gosh, we're not even done yet. Okay, here we go. Giga Gaia. This is the last one. This is actually gonna go up to 2 gigs. I bet you anything it's gonna go all the way up to 2 gigs. This is crazy. I didn't know this. I didn't know the game was gonna make me do this. I thought I was gonna get a chance to back out after fighting Zeal, but... I guess not. Pear Blaster. Dude, that's called Double Hand Blaster, not Pear Blaster. We're not eating fruit. Eating fruit. I wonder if anybody's ever drawn fan art of all these little, of all these, like, random little Lavos critters. It reminds me of the Sin Spawn in Final Fantasy X. Let's use ice water, and you can use shock, and that should kill the hands. I think I might actually be able to hit that guy with Area Bomb, yeah. But who cares? Who cares about Sea King, right? Goldeen, with that, like, slightly questioning tone. Goldeen? Question mark? All things considered, the lag isn't that bad. You might not even be able to tell that it's lagging behind my loud-ass voice. Poor Marley doesn't really get to do anything here. You know what I just realized? I think if I back out, I'm gonna have to do this whole shit again if I come back to Lavos. Like, if I back out after phase one, I'm gonna have to do it again when I come back. I won't be able to just go on to phase two. Well, no, you know what I can do, actually? There's actually a way you can totally skip phase one. I could do that. I won't spoil what that is for people who don't know, but that might just be what I do when it's time to finally go fight Lavos for real in, like, the next episode, I guess. Pew. Commencing parts restoration. No, you don't! Man, this is gonna be a huge-ass fucking episode when we get to the end. Like... Oh, this is gonna take- I'm not gonna be able to get this up if I add the end slate to it. Okay, here we go. Now it's time for the actual fight with Lavos. That was all just a fucking preamble. Now we're actually fighting him. It's time to actually do the man in. And you know what? I'm not gonna switch my party. I'm gonna go crazy. Destruction rains from the heavens. Oh, no. Oh, boy. Oh, that wasn't so bad. Jeez, is that the best you can do, Lavos? Seriously, you didn't even do 300 to any of us. I guess I'm gonna just use Uzi Punch, because this guy basically, you know, Lavos for realsies is basically just a damage sponge. Not really that complicated. It just takes forever because of all the phases in front of it. Which is kind of ironic, considering he's supposed to be like this ultimate life form, but I guess the idea is, when you're attacking the outer shell, you're attacking the part that hasn't really evolved yet. I think the idea is that, like, his true form is, like, incubating within this shell, and when it's time for him to, like, leave, he'll hatch and then go find another planet to spread his spawn to, or something. I don't know.
What do I look like? Some kind of fucking Chrono Triggerologist? Oh, there we go. There's more than 300 damage. If only that was actually dangerous. Oh, I'm getting a Discord message. And it's making the game lag even more. Oh, it's Wallach saying good morning. Oh, dude, I'm in the middle of recording, man. ASDFGHJKL, man. Bro! I'll be right with you, so just chill out for a second. Did I just use Cure Wave? I think I just used Cure Wave by accident. Nope, okay. I thought I'd used Cure Wave. I'm always confused as to whether or not you can have more than one buff on it. Was that it? Was that it? Seriously? I only went through the Black Omen once, dude. That was pathetic. Don't wheeze like that was actually difficult. You were successful. Will there never be an end? Let's go inside. Why? Why? What possible reason could you have to believe that that wasn't the end of it right there? Oh boy. Okay. We're in pretty deep. This is creepy. It's worse than Magus's place. According to my sensors, we are close to the center. Excuse me. Well, this is creepy. But we're gonna do this next time. I didn't think this episode was gonna go on for this long. Next time on Chrono Trigger, I'll meet you in the end of time, we'll fight Specchio, and then we'll probably finish the game. At least we'll get one ending, because there's like 20 of the fucking things. Bye!